warrant of appointment of Sri Tirumupathu Raghavan Devi. By virtue of the power vested in me by close fund of Article 224 of the Constitution of India, I, Ramnath Kovind, President of India, do hereby appoint Sri Tirumupathu Raghavan Devi to be an additional judge of the Kerala High Court for a period of 2 years with effect from the date he assumes charge of his office, even at Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi, this third day of March in the year 2020, 13th Falguna 1941 Shaga, in the 71st year of the Republic of India. Signed, President of India.
I,
Tirumupathu Raghavan Devi,
having been appointed additional judge of the High Court of Kerala,
having been appointed additional judge of the High Court of Kerala,
do swear in the name of God,
do swear in the name of God,
that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established,
that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established,
that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India,
that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India,
that I will duly and faithfully and to the best of my ability, knowledge and judgment,
that I will duly and faithfully and to the best of my ability, knowledge and judgment,
perform the duties of my office without fear or favour, affection or ill will,
perform the duties of my office without fear or favour, affection or ill will,
and that I will uphold the Constitution and the laws,
and that I will uphold the Constitution and the laws. Senior advocates, members of the bar, registrars and members of the registry, advocate clerks, family, friends and well-wishers. I would like to begin by thanking the collegiums of this Honorable Court and the Honorable Supreme Court for having considered me for appointment as judge. The nice words spoken about me are heartwarming, and I should say that the good intention of making me feel welcome to this new job has been sufficiently satisfied. The reasons that weighed with the collegium of this court and the Supreme Court and the President to find me fit for the job of judging causes would not be the ones which I would have considered if I were deciding my own case. I would have been much more harsh on myself. I am glad that I did not have to be a judge in my own cause and make a fundamental mistake in administrative law. I have been entrusted with a task. I hope the Lord Almighty, who will I adorn this seat, will continue to guide me through till the logical end. My history, my past, my adventures and misadventures in life, my dreams, my apprehensions, my family, my woes, my likes, my dislikes. None of these should be of any interest to you, and I do not wish to burden your ears with such details. I can, however, say that with a little conviction that I am a product of good parenting. My father, late Ayurvedian T.R. Raghava Varier, who was an Ayurvedic doctor, and my mother, T.V. Lakshmikutty, who has been a wonderful homemaker, taught me the virtues of living simple and being honest to myself. My brother Shashi Varier has been my friend, philosopher and guide through my life. I have had several gurus in my life who have influenced me in several ways, and I carry their blessings with me. I should say that I accidentally chanced upon law as a profession. After completing my graduation, my first attempt was to try to pursue management. When I failed to qualify in IIM CAT, my father asked me to consider law. By then the admission to law colleges in Tamil Nadu were over and I applied to Calicut Law College. From there, this pursuit began. I had the good fortune of being the junior to two stalwarts in the profession, Advocate A. Vijayaraghava Varier, with whom I started practice at Thirur, and Senior Advocate P. R. Govinda Varier, who was instrumental in bringing me over from Thirur to Ernakulam. I can boast of a privilege that for 4 years, my senior was making me my morning tea. My family has been the best support for me in attaining whatever success I have had in the profession. In November 1993, I was married to Sindhu. She is working as a teacher. We are blessed with two children. My son Siddharth will complete law in a couple of months. And my daughter Maithili is in her second year BCom. I do not want to venture into expressing gratitude to my parents, my family and my well-wishers, since any expression would be found wanting. My seniors, I am sure, would have been very happy to see their ward taking up higher responsibilities. I should be making a mention of the wonderful relationships I have been able to develop over the last 31 years in this bar. I have been associated with advocates of various generations and the inputs that I have got have been tremendous. I will not be able to stop speaking if I start out with the names of my well-wishers at the bar, my associates at my senior's office, later my fellow government leaders during my short stint as senior government leader and special government leader, my classmates from my law college days have all left an indelible impression in my life. I reminisce with warm gratitude the tremendous support I received from senior advocates Sri Tri Krishnaswamy and Sri George Pondora. For the past 10 years, I have been associated with Advocate Jawahar Jose, who keeps the office going. No advocate can survive in the profession unless he is able to get the help of good advocate clerks and office staff. I have been very lucky to have some of the good clerks and office staff. I remember with gratitude advocate clerks Unniyattan and Dinesh, who left us for the heavenly abode. An advocate can survive in the profession only if he is able to have satisfied clients. I gratefully remember my clients who trusted me with their briefs and kept me going. I do not want to roll a dice and predict what I am likely to do in this job. With the help of the Honorable the Chief Justice and my brother and sister judges, I should be able to perform the duties cast on me reasonably well. I am sure my friends at the bar will not allow me to make many a mistake in the job. Thank you.